It was Sidney Crawford's first ever appearance at a Paris Couture show. Struggling to get to his ringside seat was hubby Richard Gere. But the real star of this fine-tuned spectacle was fashion's Madame Butterfly, Karl Lagerfeld.
It's really flirty and flippy in a very naive, positive, childlike way. Uh-huh. It's not a rough 80s statement here. Yeah. It's very soft and it's very right for the times.
Yes, indeed. Oh, yeah.
Let's talk about what we don't like. Mr. Karl Lagerfeld for Chanel. That's CC. Everybody wearing those terrible initials on their ears, breasts, chains with CC all the way down to their C's. Oops. I want you to know it was the worst piece of C I have seen in many, many years.
Love him or leave him, Karl Lagerfeld thrives on getting strong reactions to his witty and sometimes wacky sense of style. His haute couture slipcovers were just the latest revelation from the man who's a master at juggling the fashion media and his well-heeled fans.
But the difficult thing is to make the couture in the way to fix it together, you know, the bias with what they call droit fil and all that. That is really difficult.
I like Karl Lagerfeld's work. He's able to do sophisticated, sexy, elegant. It's just always, it's always fantastic.
Chanel, Chanel. It's all about, there's a wonderful morality play going on. It's the wife, the mistress, and the maid. Don't you see it? You know, it's all lingerie, and they're all caught in the bedroom with their hair half in rollers and bits of lingerie and stocking tops. So it's very mysterious and very sexy, but wonderful. Fabulous.
Every time you hear that.